Okay guys, today I'm going to talk about the function switch for the Lasonic 931, and this is definitely the source of headache for that radio. This is shared with the 920. These are both soldered to the PC board with these pins, and this one here is broken as well, and I'm going to make the attempt to repair this, or at least take it apart and figure out what the problem is. Now, right off the bat, you can see that inside there's a little gear that should be on this shaft. Okay, the shaft is not attached to the gear. The gear is supposed to be turning, and that in turn moves the slider back and forth. You can see inside that slider is the positioner. Okay, now if you do have a radio that is screwed, you technically could take this apart and move that to the position it needs to be in and then leave it. So if you wanted it on radio, or if you wanted it on input, you know, auxiliary or CD, or you know, line in, then you could just set it and then it's set for good. But I'm going to try and repair this. And first off, we're going to start by taking off this top piece that has the shaft on it, and it looks fairly simple. Looks like we should be able to squeeze these two together. Try and not trash them, because you're going to want to put it back together properly. These little, you can see these little tongs here, these little spreaders. That's what we're going to try and squeeze back together. My pliers are kind of crappy. Okay. Okay, so it took some finessing to get these prongs properly lined up to fit back through the slot. And that's really just the key. You squeeze those back together and make sure they're going to line up in the slot. And once they do, then you can gently pop that off. Gently. Because obviously you want to reuse this. So right there we can see inside. You can see the gear that's loose inside, and you can see that it's supposed to go on that shaft. So there's the piece, there's the shaft, and inside is the gear. There is the gear that should be on that shaft, and then here is where the gear is supposed to connect to move this thing back and forth. The gear, let me get this on camera here, should be moving that back and forth, just like that. That's all the gear does, and that's your position selector. So, the gear has come off of the shaft. Okay? And that's it. All you gotta do is put that back on. So let's find our position here. What is the optimum position for this thing here? Looks like there's the stop. Looks like looks like that is the stop position. But only trial and error will let me know if that is the actual spot. I'm going to try this a few times, move it back and forth. I'll come right back and show you the optimum position. Okay, so this little nub right here is going to go up towards the rest of the shaft. Okay, the shaft has been pounded down in a press to hold it in place. That might require some sand, some filing, and then doing the same thing again. I don't want to break the gear, but does not really want to go back on there with those little pressings out. So I'm going to file it down and then put it back on. Okay, so using a small file, I'm just going to touch this up a little bit. Sorry for the shaky hands. Just going to take those edges down. And then we're going to glue this son of a bitch back on. I might even freaking epoxy it on. They use the press to spread those, so you don't have to wait for epoxy to dry on an assembly line. Alright, so the gear up. Okay. I know this is probably agonizing to watch. I'm just checking. It looks like it has a crack in it. Yep. That's how this thing got out. It's got a crack in it. See that? So being very careful with that is going to mean all the world to saving this piece. So I'm just going to file it so this thing slides on there easily, and then I'm going to glue it. Sorry for my autofocus here. Working with what you got, you know. So obviously, if your gear is completely shattered, or you're missing the gear, or any other components are broken, you're going to have to deal with that. This piece here could be modeled and made. That is a candidate right there for 3D printing. So, there we go. Gear back in place. Aha, and there's a stop right there. Wonder which side that's supposed to be on. Guess we're going to find out here right now. Okay, so I found the combination. It's a little lock here. First, set the switch itself. There's two positions. There's that position, and then there's that position. So the white end is flush. Your switch is all the way that way. Your slider. Okay. And then you've got this. This is going to be the end. This little spring is the end of the setting. Then you take your knob. It's in between the two stops. Set it to this end. Okay. So you put that back on there. Again, switch is set all the way to that end. That end. Put this back on. And you notice that the little nub is this end over here. So then when you put this back on, you have full range to move that back and forth, and the switch moves. All I gotta do is glue that switch, or glue that gear right there, because it's got a crack in it. It's got a crack right there. Let's do that. We'll be right back. Okay, the gear and the knob have oil on them, or grease, to keep the gear lubricated. I'm going to use a little bit of isopropyl alcohol, and I'm going to clean these so that way my epoxy will attach and adhere, because that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to epoxy this son of a bitch on, and I don't give a shit after that. So, but we got to get all the original gear grease off of this thing. Yeah, you can really see the crack once this thing's been cleaned. And this is obviously the missing link. If somebody can get a gear and have one made, you could sell that sumbitch on eBay. Okay, not very interesting video, I know. Part of the process. All right. So, we got our parts. Now, we're gonna put this together permanently with this Superman. I found this stuff works great. You can really, it's a two-part, and you can pretty much so bond water to oxygen with this stuff. I mean, you can make anything go together. You can glue Muslims to Christians with this stuff right here. Alright, let me mix it up, and we'll put it together. Okay, so using the absolute tiniest amount of epoxy, I put the gear back on. Absolutely tiny amount. And we'll put a little bit back up here on top, keeping it out of the gear. Now the beauty part about this stuff is you can sand it, and you can mold it, and you can pretty much so do anything you want with it. The only thing you can't do, just take it off of something you put it on, because it's a bitch. Okay. So there you go. Now I gotta wait for a while for that to dry. But I do not have a Lasonic 931. But I'm going to have me a working switch, so that way, when I do get me one, I can, and I know it's busted, I can just pop this bad boy in, solder it up, and I got me a working box. So that's it. You put it back together, you spread those little pins out here, at all four corners. And you're done. Working switch. Yeah. There you go. And that's how you repair the switch on a 931, 920. Have fun.